Thank you. race from start, we're not doing this. We gotta find this. I'm sorry. We're not supposed to put balloons in this side.
That hurts right now. It was on a chair.
Robert, have them tie those balloons to the fence. They gotta tie those balloons to the fence.
Finley's watching the live feed saying nothing's coming out of yours right now.
That's what I'm saying.
Newman says it's showing up on his laptop when he's watching it.
It's on the YouTube feed.
Tell right. Finley to refresh his page.
It could also be a delay.
Thank you. into it.
Good job. stand for our national anthem led by the Amundsen Orchestra and Chorus. Good evening, family, friends, faculty, and administration. Wow, class of 2023, we have done it. We are here at the end of a significant chapter in our lives, high school. Today, I have been given this immense opportunity to stand before you and share words that will conclude our lives as Vikings. This would not have been possible without the support of some special people in our lives. On behalf of the Amundsen class of 2023, I would like to extend our sincere thanks to these important people. To the families and friends who have supported us through all the highs and lows, no words can fully capture the sacrifice and dedication that you have made. We have learned so much from you, and we thank you. To the administrators, teachers, counselors, and coaches who supported us, oversaw our education, and facilitated a memorable high school experience for us, especially during our erratic sophomore year, we thank you. To my classmates, especially with whom I collaborated and with whom I struggled through the challenges that Ivy presented, I thank you. It seems like just yesterday that we first entered the crimson doors of Amundsen High School. Each of us searching for the right classroom, with maybe more than a handful of us accidentally sitting in a class full of seniors. From praying for a snow day that never came, to a pep rally interrupted by torrential rain, every laugh, every cry, and every memory of our time at Amundsen is like an image in a flipbook of our high school experience. Just like a flipbook, the accounts of our high school journey have flashed before our eyes. We will never have an instance where we will be in the same place at the same time again. Many of the faces that we see today will remain as an obscure image in the back of our minds, with the occasional instance when we are hit with a sudden burst of nostalgia, re-emerging from the dust that time and age have collected on our flipbook. As for my flipbook, there are some pages that I'd rather not remember. At times I felt like Sisyphus, condemned for eternity to roll a boulder up a mountain, endlessly rolling back to the bottom before reaching the very top. Failure notably made this journey more difficult. As the days passed, each instance of failure accumulated on the boulder that I'd push every day, continuously growing heavier and dragging me down. I'm probably not alone in feeling this way. Now, it is not my intention to dampen the mood of this happy day, but a lesson learned is a lesson shared. Life comes charging at us, throwing setbacks that obstruct our vision and demotivate us. Some of us may find that life beats us down more, creating more losses than others due to circumstances, disapproval, or maybe even because of the tendency to take a lot of risks. Ultimately, no matter what background we may have, failure will find each of us. The bigger question is not if we will fail, but how we will ultimately use our failures to become stronger. And I've learned from my experiences here at Amundsen that failure is simply the unfinished phase of our latest challenge. Making success contingent on the status of whether or not we have achieved our desired outcome will only leave us feeling inadequate. Don't treat failure as a reflection of who you are. Rather, acknowledge it and perceive it as a chance to pivot your course of action. We can learn this from Thomas Edison during his attempts at creating the first light. Edison went through countless trials in order to perfect design, and after 14 months, he accomplished it. In the 1920s, a journalist asked Edison how it felt to fail 1,000 times in his attempt to invent the incandescent light. He replied, "I didn't fail 1,000 times. The light bulb was an invention with 1,000 steps." Mindset is the most important aspect of success and failure. It is a natural component of growth. We have all experienced failure in one way or another, whether it be in sports, school, or a relationship. Our failures have made us tenacious and equipped for far more demanding hurdles than life as an adult will impose. As we embark and diverge onto all our various aspirations, we may be confronted with a moment where we have experienced our 999th failure, or as Thomas Edison liked to call it, the 999th step. Remember, trust the process. You could be one step away from your life or moment. Thank you, and congratulations, class of 2020. Thank you, Esther. You know, really quick, they say rain on your wedding day is a sign of good luck. So we're just taking this light sprinkle as a way of blessing you all on your graduation day. So hang tight, you still all look beautiful, your hair looks great. Thank you, Esther. Now I would like to introduce our assistant principal, Mr. Nguyen, who will announce the students who are ranked top 10 academically in this class.
The 10 is an honor and a privilege to get to do this. This year's top 10 is really from all over the world, and my apologies if I don't quite pronounce your name correctly. There are two students tied for 9th. When I call your name, please stand up and remain standing. Number 9, Lisa Vital. Also tied for 9th, Faith Gunguru. Number 8, Aries Okumbe. Tied for 6th, Juliana Vito Ortega. Also 6th, Kashmala Khalid. Tied for 3rd, Melanie Reyes. Also 3rd, Fasia Ogunsola. Also coming in 3rd, Sainabu Akinbulu. Our South Victorian, Marta Shaminska. And our Victorian, Esther Kim. Thank you.
Congratulations to you all on your academic success. Now I would like to introduce our assistant principal, Ms. Murray, who will announce military commitments.
It is my privilege to be able to introduce to you those members of our graduating class who have made commitments to service in our United States military. We wish you the best, and we support you and congratulate you in your service, and we thank you most of all. If I can have the students, as I mention your names, please stand and remain standing. And again, this is a very international group, and I'm going to do my best to get your names right, but I apologize if I don't do it all correctly. Melencio Alberto, United States Marines. Eddie Alvarez, United States Coast Guard. Eloisa Puerto, Army National Guard. Andrew Sanchez, Army National Guard. Josue Sigüenza, United States Marines. Aiden Smalley, Military. Ekaterini Sogas, United States Marines. And Parut Vasantakitinju Kumyorn, Army National Guard. Thank you and congratulations on your commitments.
Good evening. I would like to congratulate those students whose efforts have earned college credit while here at Amundsen. First, I would like to recognize the 174 students who successfully earned dual credit. They took college-level courses while still enrolled in high school, and 8 of them even earned more than a semester of college credit. They can be identified by blue medals with silver ribbons. Students, please stand.
Thank you.
Well, next, I would like to acknowledge the 45 students who earned the 2023 Illinois State Seal of Red Literacy for commendation by demonstrating their high levels of proficiency in English and the world language. Whether you continue developing your home language or learned one or more languages at school, you have worked hard and we are here to have your accomplishment recognized. This aligns with Amundsen's priorities and visions of promoting multilingualism, biliteracy, and intercultural flexibility as key contributors to students' college and career success. They can be identified by having medals with white or yellow ribbons, and those students can please stand. Thank you, can be seated. So tonight is about celebrating students, and I'm so thrilled to continue by also announcing our next award winner. Every time I see this particular student, I am greeted with a joyful smile and a happy heart. And because this student is such an inspiration to everyone at Amundsen, it seemed only fitting to include a few quotes from other staff members. Here are just a few highlights. Very kind and has a gentle nature. An old soul that brings positivity and calmness to the people around him. Secretly, one of the funniest kids in the school. Friendly, focused, inquisitive, and determined. A really engaging youth leader for Freshman Connection and gave the incoming freshmen a great experience. Extremely reliable, and we can always depend on him to help set up and take down for senior breakfast, homecoming, and haunted house. The best Santa Claus this year, and everyone enjoyed him. And I personally would like to add, after seeing him sing a solo at the chorus concert, who knew he could sing like that? This student embodies the school values of being accountable, honorable, and scholarly, and has done all of this while persevering through challenges and personal tragedy. Sam Hudabet, please come up and accept your Valentine's Award. This senior class in particular has a few angels walking among them today. Let's pause to remember the young lives that aren't here to walk beside you. We honor their memory and saved these seats for them today at graduation. While not in your programs, I'd like to take this time to speak about Fabian Wilmot, who attended Amundsen during his freshman and sophomore years. He was beloved by his extensive family and friends. His gentle spirit and kind demeanor are just a few of his commendable attributes. His courage and strength will be remembered always. A friend of Fabian asked that this quote be read in his honor. Those we love don't go away. They walk beside us every day. Unseen, unheard, but always near, still loved, still missed, and always dear. Now I'd like to welcome Geraldine Vega and some of her peers, to speak on behalf of another Viking who cannot be with us here today.
Good evening. My name is Angel Guillen. I'd like to take this moment during our celebration to remember a classmate and friend of ours who is no longer with us. Truly, he was much more than a friend, much more than a student. He was family. Esteban Muvianos started his journey with us as a freshman, but was sadly taken from us too soon.
It is said, when friendship leaves us through death, we feel cheated in life. Life doesn't play fair, so I vowed to win the game for us both. Esteban was definitely one of those people in our life. Oh, shit, sorry. Esteban was definitely one of those people. Our lives haven't been the same since you left us. Steve, even though you aren't here with us physically, we know you're always here spiritually, and I know that after everything we've done, I know you're looking out for us from up there. And I know you're sitting back there. We love you.
Le queremos agradecer a los padres, hermana y familiares de Esteban por estar aquí esta tarde con nosotros. Thank you.
Now for your listening pleasure, the Amundsen Orchestra. Amundsen chorus.
So with planning for the of the weather, we kept the diplomas and covers back inside the school. So for the purpose of graduation, students will be reusing the same cover photos for photo purposes at this time. Now for the moment you've all been waiting for. Are you ready for it?
Osman Abdi. Mighty Amaraz. Abigail Blazik. Jocelyn Shamas. Sam Cohen. Mayo Cook-Sakali. Madeline Culver. Jocelyn Herbacio Padilla. Ilya Gassami. Sophia Hashimi. Giovanni Damian. Juan Alfredo Munoz Hernandez. Juan Luis Munoz Hernandez. Ashawn Holder. Margot Lavie. Juliana Lopez. Victor Maya. Yeah. Joseph Mokir. Pearson Oliver. Eloisa Porto. Jeffrey San Juan. Matthew Garcia. Camila Segura. Josue Seguinha. Yareli Vacoria.
Mia Kita.
person. Alexandra Putisena. Derek Soto. Aiden Stoker.
Trebovic.
Joseph Valdovinos.
Christopher Rito. Moses Castañeda. Margaret Cervantes. Lisbeth Garcia.
Down.
Patricia Lozada. Enzo Mili.
Jonathan Hiyahosa. Talia Kalasidis. Ava Kaplan. Levi Kaplan. Esther Kim. Emmanuel Lopez. Andreas Macedo. Montserrat Morales. Adam Mish. Akhtan Mukhtakarov. Dominica Patina. Tyron Randall. Bryce Russell. Julian Sabalka. Ekaterini Trogas. Mazur Yulich. Jardeline Vega. Theo Lamis. Isabella White. Tammy Olamoyova.
Mr. Westergaard, and here's number 308. Shade Adiju. Yeah. Coraima Aguilar Vasquez. Jacob Ballinger. Pip Bowling. Holden Boyle. Cara Clements. Noah Dimas. Dennis Aaron. Piper Evans. Alex Filippelli. Jocelyn Garcia Duenas. Diego Hernandez Flores. Michael Jimenez. George Magana the Third. Sophia Morgan. Elena O'Brien. Patty O'Shea. Juliana Ramirez. Isaiah Rowe. James Sabia. Anna Skinner. Emma Stewart. Levi Thomas Jenkins. Autumn Young. Jonathan Zamora.
Yeah. Vanessa.
Christopher Pinto.
Cesar Rosas.
Good evening. I'm a
Mr. Jakovic, and I have the honor of introducing referee 315. Mahmoud Abdul Latif. Norberto Bernabe. Drake Fitzgerald Clements. Soledad Cornelio Cornelio. Leonardo Esparza. Isabella Flores. Emerson Sophia Graves. Thais Eifinger. Josue Laboya. Ella Lowe. Malcolm Long. Michael Maldonado. Fabia Ogunshola. Mariana Rodas. Angel Romero. Damian Shannon. Madison Smith. Alexandra Squirtling. Kevin Tawada Rita. Toma Toma. Allison Vargas. Glenn Vesita. Paolo Vives. Jeremiah Young. Julissa Yuki Lima.
Hello, my name is Max Hawkins. I'll be running for advisory 314. Layla Oligich.
Holden Austin. Daniel Carrera Sanchez. Valeria Castillo Casiano. Christopher Clark. Clarence De Guzman. Brenda Garmendia Valdez. Joshua Jones. Rex Krim. Atis Lewis.
Congratulate our
Amundsen High School class of 2023. To the class of 2023, this is your day. And on your day, I'd like to recognize two groups of people that have been instrumental in your path to graduation. First, to your families. Your families have been by your side for your entire journey. They have supported you, believed in you, and served as your biggest cheerleaders. This, without a doubt, is one of the proudest and most memorable days of their lives. And so I would like to ask all of our graduates to join me now in one of our Amundsen's honor commencement traditions. Please rise. Think of the family members and friends who supported you on this special journey. Find them in the stands, turn to them, and please join me in saying these words to them. Thank you.
Never before did we foresee
or anticipate the unique curveballs and barriers we were pressed to overcome. These experiences have undoubtedly challenged each of you, mentally, physically, and emotionally. While moving through high school during the most challenging of circumstances, you not only made it through, but you thrived. You have demonstrated tremendous accomplishment and success in the classroom, on stage, on our athletic fields, and in serving our community. And from everything I have witnessed from this class, you have demonstrated empathy, kindness, and passion. As a class, you have modeled for our entire community what it means to be a true Viking, accountable, honorable, and scholarly. And over the past 4 years, there's been a lot of talk about lost time. Today, I invite you to reframe the pandemic from being lost time to found time. The world forced you to take the time to develop skills you will use for the rest of your life. Grit and determination, resilience and perseveration. You are forced to endure tremendous discomfort, disappointment, uncertainty, and fear. The process was rough, but the product is beautiful. Just look at all of you here today. Wow, you did it, and you did it in a big way. Amundsen's class of 2023 has been accepted to colleges and universities across the country, ranging from DePaul University, Loyola University, to the University of Michigan, American University, St. Louis University, and the list goes on. The class of 2023 was offered scholarships totaling almost $41 million. Members of the class of 2023 have been awarded scholarships from a range of institutions, organizations, and private donors, including Posse, QuestBridge, Jorndt Joy of Learning, Amundsen Athletic Foundation, and many more. But your achievements go well beyond college acceptances and scholarship money. You've competed in sporting events in which you had to dedicate hundreds of hours to training, and even sometimes at 6 a.m. in the morning. You have created beautiful and thought-provoking works of art, and had the bravery to share them with others. You have stood on a stage and delivered powerful musical and dramatic performances. Meanwhile, behind the scenes, you have built sets, made costumes, or designed sound and lighting. You have organized clubs, pep rallies, and school dances. You have supported and enriched your local community through an array of service learning projects. These are all very impressive and all very visible achievements. But it is also important to celebrate those less visible accomplishments. The things that your teachers, friends, or even parents might not know about you. For some of you, this might be a time when you had to work up the courage to ask for help. It might be mending a struggling relationship. It might be managing the stress of schoolwork. It might be having to work harder than everyone else around you just to get the same grade. It might be recovering from an illness or an injury and then fighting to keep up with your studies. During your time at Amundsen, some of you lost people close to you. Some of you experienced anxiety or depression. For some of you, on some days, just getting up and getting to school was an achievement worth celebrating. These are the things that you do not get grades for, and there are no trophies or certificates, but might be just among some of the most significant accomplishments. There is no noble prize for dealing with loss. There's no Pulitzer Prize for supporting a friend in trouble. And no Oscar for getting out of bed when you just don't feel like facing the world. So I've spoken about your achievements, both visible and hidden. And this is the point I'm supposed to give you advice. However, I've been struggling with this idea since I started writing my speech. How do you give one piece of advice to 361 incredibly diverse group of students? As you know, you are entering a world that will present you with new and different types of challenges and obstacles through those big life moments and those smaller day-to-day ones. And I could stand here today and tell you how I think you can be resilient in your future endeavors. But quite honestly, you have been the model for so many of us in our community. In the face of adversity, you have maintained a steady focus on your goals, stayed true to your values. This has been a recipe for resilience that both the class of 2023, and quite frankly, all of us, as we navigate an increasingly complex and challenging world. Class of 2023, we admire your resilience. We are proud of your accomplishments, and we are so excited for each of you and your future. Today, I stand here with the greatest respect and admiration for what all of you have accomplished. And now, the moment you've been waiting for. Graduates, by the power in... it's working. And we're still hearing this. Why isn't it working? Try again. Check it.
You know, as Amundsen's newest assistant principal, I'm sure I got this after delivering like 5,000 IB exams with a microphone. So this is fine. You can do this.
Hang on a second. Let me take a look at my sheet. Now, based on my calculation, you've only been principal for 147 days out of 333 days. So the mic may not work for you for the second half.
I'm
you shut up like four times.
Don't fuck me, God. Don't fuck me until four times.
Four times.